Hi there, I'm Robin Zander, and I wanted to take just a minute today to talk about something that has been a lifelong, or at least maybe call it the last 10 years, daily practice for me. And this is a matter of how we show up in interpersonal relationships. I am currently overlooking the Marin Hills. You can barely see San Francisco in the background. And I, as I often am just off of a coaching call with a client. I advise fast-growing startups on a variety of different factors that relate to humans, the humans who work within the organizations, the humans that they cater to, but how do you build more thriving organizations, marketing, operations, sales, etc. And it just struck me, getting off of this phone call with the client, how important it is that we show up loving with people in our lives. And loving isn't a word that we generally use to describe a client-consultant relationship. It's maybe, if you're really fortunate, something that you use to describe your family life. But it's definitely not something that we use at work. Showing up lovingly with my colleagues, or my employees, or my boss, is just not in the cards. It's not something we do. And yet, it's so important. When we show up with presence, with attention, with a loving attitude that puts an emphasis on how the other person is feeling in that moment, we're able to perceive more. And scientifically, there's a lot behind this. When we're in a state of physical pain, for example, just to use the physical pain analogy, we experience less. So if you're standing on a tack or in a state of chronic pain, you have the ability to perceive less. And in the same way, when you're in a state of psychological stress or emotional distress, you can feel less. If you take this to the next logical step, if you are more present, more at ease. If we take this to the next logical step, which is being intentionally present and intentionally loving with colleagues, with friends, certainly with friends or with romantic partners, but I'm actually talking specifically about work. If we're able to show up in some way prioritizing their best interests, or at least paying attention to what their interests might be, we're able to perceive more, notice how is this person feeling, and act accordingly. But if I'm so caught up in my own stuff and thinking about what's out there and not what's here, and what the other person is experiencing, I'm less available, and thus less able to help. I want to make a quick intro. In the background here, we have my puppy, Riley, who likes to stand on this rock and survey her domain. I'll be back tomorrow with another pointer. Robin Zander here. Thanks for subscribing. If you would like to learn more, come visit us. The website is www.wantmotion.com.